Hello, friends. Hope you guys are having an amazing day so far. It is Monday, December 14th. So we're going to be doing day 14 of the From Heaven Advent devotional from A.W. Tozer. So I started this earlier this month, and I told you guys when I hopped in here to do kind of these daily or these weekly Bible studies, I was going to actually be doing these Advents, okay? So it is a little different here in my setup. My light is on. Usually my light is off because I get really cool natural light right in front of my window. But the days are getting darker sooner, and so the light was just not going to be good. So I'm like, let's just turn on that light, all right? So let's get to it. Today's title is called Let Us Prepare Now, all right? And the passage is Matthew 25, verse 13. So it says, therefore, keep watch, because you do not know the day or the hour. Okay, so A.W. Tozer says, it was John Milton who said that hope springs eternal in the human breast. Indeed, hope is such a vital thing that were it to die out of the heart of mankind, the burden of life could not long be sustained. So we cling to hope as humans, okay? And we are not, like, he's pretty much saying that we won't be sustained, we won't make it if we have no hope in our hearts, you know? He says, but precious as this hope may be, it is yet, when it is ill-found, a dangerous thing. So when our hope is not what it's supposed to be, it is ill, it is damaged, then that is a very damaging thing, obviously, okay? The hope, for instance, which almost all people have of long life here on earth, can be for many a deadly snare, a fatal delusion. The average man, when he thinks of his future, suspends reason, falls back on unreasonable hope, and creates for himself an expectation of peaceful and unnumbered days yet to come. So the average person, the average Joe who has hope in life, just thinks of his life as, yes, it's kind of like a question mark, but I'm gonna have these long, peaceful days. You know, I'm not gonna die tomorrow. I have plenty of years in my life, right? This blind optimism works all right till the last day. The inevitable last day that comes to all, meaning the day that we perish, the day we die. Okay, then it betrays its victim into the pit from which there is no escape. So the average Joe lives like this, thinks they're not going to die anytime soon. They have plenty of years to live. And then when death does come, because it will come to everyone, you know, obviously it's going to be too late. The perils of groundless hope threaten the Christian too. This is very sad. And I agree. I feel like a lot of Christians put their hope, or actually even think this way. I think that they're going to, and I'm guilty of it. I feel like a lot of times saying, yeah, I'm going to have plenty of time to do that. Plenty of, you know, years ahead of me to be able to get to that, you know, sooner or later. And these, we are people who our hope is in Christ, right? And we're going to see here why that's faulty, why we should not be thinking like the average Joe. James in the Bible, sharply rebuked the believers of his day for presumptuously assuming an earthly future they had no real assurance would be theirs. God does not promise tomorrow. That's the thing. Nowhere in the Bible does it say, okay, tomorrow is definitely going to come in a sense of you're definitely going to be alive tomorrow. We think that way because of the fact that we're alive today and we had a yesterday, right? And yesterday, you know, we thought, yes, it's going to happen. And here we are, morning comes and we're alive. And that is what we are used to seeing in life. So maybe that's where our hope, our blind hope comes from, because we think chances are we're not, because days just keep coming. Okay, it's like a false assurance. So again, James warns the people in his time saying this. And I think he uses the King James Version of scripture. So I'm going to try to power through this. Hopefully you guys can follow me. It says, well, he's reading James 4, 13 to 16. So if you have your Bible in an easier version, maybe ESV, NIV, go ahead and turn to it. So James 4, 13 to 16, he says, go to now, ye that say, today or tomorrow we'll go into such a city, and continue there a year, buy and sell, and get gain. Whereas you or ye not know what shall be on the morrow, meaning we don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. For what is your life? Is it even a vapor that appeareth for a little time and then vanishes away? Like, our life is like a vapor, that you see it, and as soon as you see that it's there, it's gone. For that ye ought to say, so what we are supposed to say is, if the Lord will, we shall live and do this or do that. But now you rejoice in your boasting. All such rejoicing is evil. For me to rejoice in the tomorrow is evil because I don't know what's going to happen again. It's not promised. So if anything, our vocabulary should be, if the Lord wills. Okay? Would it not be good for us to put away the vain dreams of countless earthly days and face up to the blunt fact that our days on earth may actually not be many? For the true church, there is a way, the possibility that Christ may return. So us, his people, we know that he is going to come. Some good and serious souls hold this to be more than a possibility, for it seems to them, as it seems to this writer, that the earth is grown old and the judgment is near. So we know when the day does come, it's one less day that we have to wait until Christ comes. Okay, that should be your mindset. All right, and the voices of the holy prophets are sounding in our ears, like, he's coming, the end is coming. That should be what is resonating in our minds, that the prophets also, I mean, the Bible is saying this. And when he comes, there will not be a moment's choice, not an added day or an hour in which to make frantic last-minute preparations. Then he reads Luke 21, 34 to 36. Again, I'm going to read the King James. If you have your Bible, turn to it. He says, "And take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged and surfeiting, and drunkenness, and cares of this life, and so that day come upon you unaware. For as a snare shall it come on all them that dwell on the face of the whole earth. Watch you therefore and pray always, that you may be accounted worthy to escape these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man." Meaning, we have to be ready every day. I have to be ready in my heart, in my life, that if tomorrow comes, and I'm not here because I have been taken with Christ, I am ready, okay? Altogether, apart from the prophetic expectations of devout men, there is the familiar fact of death itself. So if Christ does not come tomorrow, I could still die, okay? Of those Christians who had died, Paul said simply, some are fallen asleep. Of the Christians that we see in Scripture, and also the ones who are dying now, today, this year, 1 Corinthians 15, 6 says that they have fallen asleep. What a vast and goodly company they make, those sleeping saints, and how their number will be increased this year. And which ones among us can give assurance that he may not join them before all the days of the year have run their course? So who here can say, well, I'm not going to join them this year? We can't, because we don't know. Since we know not what a day may bring forth, does it not appear to be the part of wisdom to live each day as if it were to be the last? Any preparation we will wish we had made, let us make it now. Anything we will wish we had done, let us do it today. Any gift that we will wish we had made, let us make it while time is on our side. At the great unveiling, there will be other emotions besides joy. There will be grief and shock and self-reproach and disillusionment. But it need not be so for you and for me. If we will but use the information we have at hand, if we will make the advantage of the opportunities that lie beside our path and the promises that just like uncut diamonds from the sacred scripture. Yesterday may have been marked by shameful failure, prayerlessness, backsliding. Today, all that can be changed, and tomorrow. If there is for us an earthly tomorrow, it can be filled with purity, power, radiant, fruitful service. So let's not look at yesterday and say, man, yesterday was just like, let's not get caught up with yesterday and saying, man, I didn't do this. I was backsliding. I didn't pray. I didn't read my Bible. No, let's look at that by changing that and saying, let me do that today and let that be my plan for tomorrow, if the Lord wills and if I am here. Okay. The big thing is to be sure we are not lulled to sleep by a false hope. that we do not waste our time dreaming about days that are not to be ours. The main thing is to make today serve us by getting ready for our possible tomorrow. Then whether we live or die, whether we toil on in the shadow or rise to meet the returning Christ, all will be well. So let us not be caught up into this false hope that this world has, thinking I'm going to have days to come. No, we don't know at all, but let us be ready today if tomorrow possibly does come or if it doesn't. If we are to die or if Christ were to return, let us be prepared in our hearts and our minds to await for that day, okay? All right, guys, that's about it. Stay tuned for a few messages for myself. If you are interested in this book, just go to the description box below and I'll have the name of it and also some other recommendations for Advent readings for this month. Don't forget, our hope in life and death is in Christ Jesus. Love you all, and I will see you on my next video, Lord willing. Bye. Hey friends, thank you so much for taking the time to watch my videos. It really does mean the world to me that you take time out of your busy schedule to check me out. So thank you so much. I have a few messages to share with you guys. They won't take long at all, I promise. So number one, I accept prayer requests. There's a list that we have here at my house that me and my family pray for every single day. So if you have a prayer request and you want us to add you to the list, just go ahead and contact me. You can leave a comment below, or you can email me or contact me through any of my social media platforms, and we will go ahead and add you to that list. Number two, if you are on Instagram or Facebook, you should totally be following me. Why? Because I post a lot more content there than I do here. I share with you guys just my everyday life, pictures of my kids, recipes, what I do on the Insta stories and all that good stuff. So if you are there, go ahead and follow me. And number three, if you are not already part of this family, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so that every time I upload a new video, you get notified. We have so much fun here. I post videos on my life. I do vlogs. I do makeup reviews. I do recipes. And also, I do Bible studies. So if you're interested, go ahead and join our family. We would love to have you. Alright guys, so that's about it. That was nice, short, and sweet for you guys. Thank you again for watching. Don't forget, our hope in life and death is in Christ Jesus. Love you all, and I will see you on my next video, Lord willing. Bye!